flies are there, fruit flies are there still, right, because it's attractive. So I am placing the cardboard inside, right, on top of all of that, and I've actually covered it again. Fruit flies are so, you know, loving everything, so they are there still. So the cardboard is there. So in a few hours or a few days, I shall check to see what's happening. Shake it around a little bit. So I have removed the paper towel, and that was actually being held down by elastic band from the jar, with the mixture with the banana, the yeast, and the bread, right? In this mixture, I had some wild fruit flies actually trapped. It was probably about 30 or more fruit flies, as was shown in previous videos. Now, I shared with you a day ago that I placed a piece of cardboard in the dry cardboard. I said wet piece of paper in the other video. Yes, it could, but the cardboard works better, right? So I placed the dry cardboard in it, and the dry cardboard is for the maggots to actually walk on. They will crawl towards it after some time, and they will come up to the top in search of oxygen. Now, if you look very carefully, you will see a few of these maggots moving, right? They are moving towards the cardboard, those fine things there. Yeah, those are fruit fly maggots. Over time they will be, yeah, they are, you see a fruit fly there on the side, right? Just like how you have the normal fly starts out as those maggots on meat and all that, fruit flies do start off as maggots. These are these are not flightless fruit flies, so therefore I am gonna still have to place the paper towel over the jar, so should in case by accident they develop into fruit fly before I actually get to it to feed my fish, I can just allow them to stay there and probably continue a culture over time. Now, these fruit fly maggots will be used to feed my small fish, such as my live bearers, right? And also, they can be used to feed my emboma cichlids, right? Fruit fly maggots are filled with nutritional fat and protein, and it allows your fish to actually grow very fast and remain healthy, right? I am trying to zoom in so that you can actually see the maggots moving around in the mixture, right? The mixture is not smelling stink, it's just okay, fruity smell. I used banana, ripe banana, and I can just smell the ripe banana still resonating in my nose, right? And that's just okay for me, right? So culturing fish food, live fish food at home, it doesn't require much. It's cheap, it's you know, feasible. You just need to have patience, and in some instances you need to plan ahead. So you have your aquarium fish that is gonna have babies. You plan all of this before. You feed your fish nutritious live food, so that the babies are born healthy and strong. And for those persons having fish that's gonna give babies very soon, what you can also do is to practice the culturing of other live fish food that can actually hold in the fish mouth, right? Now, it's a small amount of maggots formed so far. And point to note, I did not spend a cent actually getting these fruit fly maggots. These fruit fly maggots are wild fruit fly maggots. I just put the mixture together and place it out into my yard, and eventually the fruit flies actually found it, right? Over time these maggots will develop wings and they will start to fly, but I don't want them to start to fly. I want them to go on that piece of cardboard, and actually I can, you know, use them to feed my fish, right? This is just the easier way to actually culture fruit fly maggots. Now I will do a video on the process of actually feeding my fish in a few days time. This video is just showing you the process, showing you, you know, the time lapse as to what happened during the process. So the maggots are moving through the fruit mixture, consuming and getting larger, and the larger they get, the more filling it is for my fish. Thank you very much for stopping by. Thank you very much for watching. I hope that you have been enjoying the series so far. Yes, and some of these things that I've done, I shared it with you. It's my first, so I appreciate everyone's enthusiasm and encouragement. Bye bye for now. Catch you next time. Peace out.